Now here is why cork grips should not be fitted to a bike if you're thinking of ever taking them back off again. I need these brake levers, these diacomps, for the old Claude Butler, and I put these cork grips on this tandem about 10 years ago. I don't want to sacrifice them because they're nice grips, but my usual method would be to push this little driver underneath, lift up, squirt some lube in from there and wiggle this around and let the lube soak in. As soon as I try and do that on these, this is what will happen. That cracking there, that isn't caused by me tonight, but that is what will happen. And the cork has been shellacked, which really makes it worse. So the only thing I can do is just keep moving it very, very slowly. I'm wondering, no, I can't even take this end off either. That's not a cap, that's the actual structure of the grip. And the cork is a dressing on top. So cork grips, lovely things. But if you're going to use cork grips, there's only one type you should use, and that is these Ergon, because they're lock-on. You undo that clamp and the slide strip back on, they're never actually bonded to the handlebars, and they're wonderful grips. Expensive, but brilliant. Don't use these cheap things. Right, on I go. One off. So what I'm going to do is that now. Probably put it back on the same bike with its new lever. Now for the other one. Oh, 25 minutes of my life that I'll never get back. Phew!